Hello there. This is the time of the year when law school aspirants across India are filling in the application form for the Common Law Admission Test, that is the CLAT 2016. Now, in this edition of CLAT, it is mandatory to rank the preferences of the 17 national law universities and at the time of registration itself. And many students are confused. They often come up to me and ask, "Sir, what is the order in which I should fill up these universities? And what order should I rank these universities so that I get the best possible university for myself?" So in this video, this is my attempt to explain in brief what should your thought process be when you are trying to rank all the 17 national law universities. To give you a brief background of what the CLAT is, the Common Law Admission Test is an All India Entrance Examination which is conducted on rotation by the 17 national law universities, the NLUs, as of 2016. And this is for admission to both the undergraduate and postgraduate degree programs. Now, the selection process that I'm talking about refers to the UG CLAT, the undergraduate CLAT. That is the 5-year integrated course which is offered by the 17 national law universities. And the 17 national law universities which are actually participating in CLAT 2016 include NLSIU Bangalore, NALSAR Hyderabad, NLIU Bhopal, WBNUGS Kolkata, NLU Jodhpur, HNLU Raipur, GNLU Gandhinagar, RML NLU Lucknow, RGNUL Punjab, CNLU Patna, NUALS Kochi, NLUO Cuttack, NUSRL Ranchi, NLU GAA Guwahati, DSNLU Vishakhapatnam, TNNLS Tiruchirappalli, and the latest entrant this year is MNLU, which is the Mumbai National Law University. Now, as mentioned on the CLAT website itself, the official CLAT website itself, this list which is mentioned is as per the year of establishment of the respective NLU. It has nothing to do with a ranking because there is no official ranking which the CLAT committee announces. So these 17 universities are simply according to the year of establishment. So the first national law university was NLS Bangalore, the second to be established was NALSAR Hyderabad, the third was NLIU Bhopal, and so on. Here's an interesting fact. RGNUL Punjab is the one which is conducting the CLAT 2016. So these 17 national law universities have to be ranked according to the order of preference by the candidate when they are filling in the application form. And the biggest question is, how do I select the order of preference among the listed universities? So this is the process which I normally recommend that the students should follow. Forget your expected score and your All India rank, right? Don't assume that if I get this score or this rank, what should I do, and so on. Assume for the sake of this exercise that you are All India rank 1. You are the topper of the CLAT, which means you have a choice of selecting between all 17 NLUs. All 17 NLUs are willing to give you admission. So if you had a choice of selecting any one of the 17 national law universities, right, then which one would be your first choice? So if you're willing, if they are willing to give you admission into any one of the 17 NLUs, which one would you take admission in? Once you have decided that, simply mark that as your preference number 1. Now, you have marked the first preference. Now, think like this. Supposing your first preference is not available to you. Let us say you have marked College X as the first college that you wish to get an admission in. But supposing X is the only college in which you cannot take admission. The remaining 16 are still open. Then in that case, what would be your second choice? Supposing X is not available, then from the remaining 16, what would be your choice? Once you have selected that, mark that as your preference number 2 and follow this process, so on and so forth, right? If the first one is not available, which would be your best choice? If the second is not available, then again, which would be your best choice? Keep on doing this exercise till you have marked all the 17 national law universities. So this process will help you decide the order in which you have a preference for the particular NLUs. The merit preference system which they have mentioned is the system for allotting seats at various universities under CLAT should work something like this. When your turn for allotment comes, that is, you have given the CLAT, your score and your All India rank has been decided. So a select number of students have been called in for the admissions. So when your turn for allotment comes, the committee would take a look at the list which you have filled in as your order of preference of the 17 national law universities. So when your turn for allotment comes, the committee checks your first preference on the list. If your first marked preference is available, it would be allotted to you and it is done. Now, only in case the first university that you decided is not available, there is no seat left in your first preference, then whatever is your second preference, they will check if any seat is available that should be allotted to you. So in short, they would keep checking your list of preferences from 1 to 17 and allot the first college in that list, that is the first college which is in your list of preferences that has a seat available at your time of allotment. As an example, now supposing I have filled NLSIU Bangalore as my number one choice, my first preference. NALSAR Hyderabad is my second choice. WB NUGS Kolkata is my third choice, and so on and so forth. I have listed all the 17 NLUs. Now, supposing after the CLAT examination, the All India rankings have been announced, and according to merit rank, they keep calling the students. So when my turn for allotment comes, the committee checks my first choice. Now in my list, remember, my first choice was NLSIU. They check, is a seat available there? If the number of students ahead of me have made such choices that yes, there is some seat available at NLSIU for me, then I'm simply allotted that seat and my allotment is done. But supposing my ranking is such that all the seats of NLSIU have already been filled before I could be allotted one, then they will check my second choice on my preference list. Now remember, my second choice was NALSAR. So now they will check, is the seat available at NALSAR? Yes, I'm simply allotted that seat and my allotment is done. If NALSAR is not available, they check my third choice, which is WB NUJS. If available, I'll be given a seat there. No, move on to my fourth preference, so on and so forth. So this is the way my seats are allotted to me. Let's take another example. Supposing at the time of filling in the list of preferences, I happen to fill GNLU, the Gujarat National Law University, as my first preference. Let us say RML NLU is selected as my second preference and NLSIU Bangalore is being filled by me as my third preference. Now this is just for sake of example. I decide my first preference is GNLU, second is RML NLU, third is NLSIU Bangalore, and similarly I have filled in the remaining 14 preferences. Now when my turn for allotment comes, they check my first preference. My first choice here is GNLU. So they will check, is a seat available at GNLU? Yes, it is. I simply am given the seat of GNLU irrespective of whether seats are available at the other colleges which I have indicated. Why? Because GNLU was my first choice. A seat is available in my first choice. So I am allotted that particular seat. Because my first preference was GNLU, I have already been allotted GNLU. So now even if I want a university which is below GNLU in my preference list, I cannot be given the same. So let us say I happen to be the All India rank one, right? Which means I'm eligible to appear for to get a seat at any of the 17 NLUs. But when it comes to allotment, they will check my preference, see that I have given GNLU as my first choice. So I simply will be allotted GNLU. There I cannot say, oh, I thought GNLU would be my best bet. I never expected NLS to be available to me, but because now NLS is available to me, I wish to have NLS. The simple logic, if I wanted NLS to be my number one preference, I should have indicated that as my number one choice. According to my calculations, when I filled in the application form, the university which was number one for me was GNLU, which I indicated as much on my preference list. And as GNLU is already available to me, why should they be allotting my second, third or any lower preference, right? So remember, when you're filling in your choices, your first preference should be the university which you want at the top of your list. Don't take anything else into consideration. Don't try to work out different permutations and combinations. The preference list should be as simple as which university do I want as number one, which I want as my second choice, so on and so forth. So here's a word of advice. Before you fill in the form and list out your preferences in terms of universities, research every single university, that is under every single national law university which comes under the CLAT. The brochure for every university is available on the official CLAT website. So go through that. Do as much research as possible. The location, the kind of infrastructure available, the kind of facilities provided to student, the quality of students which take admission in such institutes, And it is very easy to find out about colleges with a little bit of online research. So do your due diligence and decide along with your parents and mentors on which is the best university for you, which is the second best, and so on. Once you have done your research, work out your order of preferences and make sure that under any circumstance, that is the exact order in which you wish the universities to be allotted to you. Make an informed choice. Don't randomly fill in these 17 universities thinking that you can always make a change or you can have some setting to get your preference at a later date. No. Do your homework. We have a lot of time to fill in the entrance examination application form for CLAT. So don't randomly fill in these universities because you may come to regret it at a later date. So as I have said before, I iterate once again. Given a chance to secure admission in any one of these 17 universities, which one would you select first? That is your first choice. If only that one institute is not available from the remaining 16, which one would you select? That should be your second choice. In case 1 and 2 are not available out of the remaining 15, which one would be your choice? That is your number 3. Continue this exercise till you have filled in all 17 universities. You cannot leave any one of them. You have to indicate your preference for each one of those 17 universities. As mentioned before, the list in which the universities have been listed on the CLAT website is simply according to their year of establishment. It has nothing to do with any sort of official ranking. So make an informed choice. Wish you all the best. Perform extremely well in CLAT 2016 and may you get the university of your choice. Wish you all the best. Have a good day.